And David inquired of the Lord. 2 Samuel 5:23. When David made this inquiry, he had just fought the Philistines, and gained a signal victory. The Philistines came up in great hosts, but, by the help of God, David had easily put them to flight. Note, however, that when they came a second time, David did not go up to fight them without inquiring of the Lord. Once he had been victorious, and he might have said, as many have in other cases, I shall be victorious again, I may rest quite sure that if I have conquered once I shall triumph yet again. Wherefore should I tarry to seek at the Lord's hands? Not so, David. He had gained one battle by the strength of the Lord, he would not venture upon another until he had ensured the same. He inquired, "Shall I go up against them?" He waited until God's sign was given. Learn from David to take no step without God. Christian, if thou wouldst know the path of duty, take God for thy compass. If thou wouldst steer thy ship through the dark billows, put the tiller into the hand of the Almighty. Many a rock might be escaped, if we would let our Father take the helm, many a shoal or quicksand we might well avoid, if we would leave to His sovereign will to choose and to command. The Puritan said, as sure as ever a Christian carves for himself, he'll cut his own fingers, this is a great truth. Said another old divine, he that goes before the cloud of God's providence goes on a fool's errand, and so he does. We must mark God's providence leading us, and if providence tarries, tarry till providence comes. He who goes before providence, will be very glad to run back again. I will instruct thee and teach thee in the way which thou shalt go, is God's promise to his people. Let us, then, take all our perplexities to him, and say, Lord, what wilt thou have me to do? Leave not thy chamber this morning without inquiring of the Lord.